Looking for Magic cards? Channel Fireball offers a wide selection of Magic singles and sealed product. You can now use the promo code LVD at checkout. Alright, pack one, pick one, or rare. Pretty disappointing, Karizev's expertise. Kind of a glorified act of treason. The Uncommons refurbished, not very good. Make Obsolete is playable, but not exciting. Fabrication Module, on the other hand, is quite good, if we end up in any sort of energy synergy deck. And even without too much energy synergy, it can be a nice mana sink. So I think that's what I'm gonna take. Welding Sparks, probably slightly better than Chandra's Revolution. At common, there's Gearseeker Serpent, which is okay. Yeah, let's take the module. Decent pack. There's Scrapper, Champion, and Aether Meltdown. Those are probably the main considerations here. Champion does have good synergy with module, but would probably be on the splash if we end up in an energy deck. But it is the highest upside card, probably. Yeah, let's take the Champion over Meltdown. Third pick. I do like Aether Swooper if we're gonna go down the energy path. There's also Thopter Arrest. We could still just be kind of a red-white aggro deck. And Thopter Arrest is excellent removal. There's Sky Skiff, which is also a nice one. I think I'd take the Swooper and then see if we can end up with a more synergistic energy deck. Blue-red could be fine. Could be Teemer still. Alright, interesting pick. So there's Voltaic Brawler, which could set up a nice aggressive energy deck. And there's Attune with Aether, which is actually a pretty high pick for these energy decks. Can also fix if we're trying to splash and end up in a slightly more ambitious, maybe four-color energy deck, for instance. But we could also just end up straight red-green, in which case Brawler's awesome. Also a big fan of Blossoming Defense if we end up with a more aggressive creature deck. And then Leave in the Dust is also quite nice in blue. I think I'm taking the Brawler, and then we'll kind of see where we end up. Yeah, I mean, could just take all the energy cards here and then hope we get some green mana fixing to play all of them. Shielded Aether Thief is pretty strong as well. If we wanted to stick to kind of the red-green beatdown plan, there's a Seed Sculptor and Ballista Charger, which are both fine. Let's take the Thief. And then now Sky Skiff seems fine. Always a useful card. And there's not too many flying creatures out there, so a 2-3 flyer does good work. There's also Salvating Gremlins, but we don't have that many artifacts. And then I could take Growth as kind of medium mana fixing, and the Revolt Enabler. Could take Reunion, which, you know, can get rid of some lands in the late game. Implements, can always play it, and then for a single blue we can sacrifice it. It's pretty slow card draw. I don't mind Reunion, especially if we don't end up blue, to give us a bit of card manipulation. Not a fan of Consulate Turrets, even in a focused energy deck. Stomper's pretty pricey to crew. So we could take a Build to Smash as a pump spell in case we end up more aggressive. Or a Metallic Rebuke if we end up kind of in the blue-red artifact deck, maybe. Which could still be the case. So I'll take a Rebuke over a Build to Smash. Although we did, of course, pass that blue-red Fabricate card at the start of the draft. So someone to our left might be in a blue-red deck. So this is our opening pack, not much left. Can speculate on a Fen Hauler in case we want to splash black. Sailback's pretty mediocre filler. Or we could take a white splash card. I'll take a Fen Hauler. Pretty late self-assembler. Can maybe end up with a couple of these. So, don't have a ton of direction yet. started out as a nice energy deck, but so far we've had to deviate a little bit. So ideally we pick up some more of those energy creatures. Implements, I'll take. So we've got outs to be a blue-red artifact synergy deck. We've got outs to be blue-red energy, or maybe teamer energy. So we still have a lot of flexibility here. That's kind of the strength of taking some of these colorless cards that can fit into any deck. Alright, second pack. Not very exciting. Don't have any vehicles to go with the Fanatic. Could take a Wander in case we end up with a multicolor pile. Or I can just take a Pyrohelix as a cheap removal spell, which is serviceable. Yeah, I'll take the Pyrohelix. Second pick, Unlicensed Disintegration. Is there any chance I can pivot into black-red? Disintegration is a very good card. Alternatively, I could take Rhino and try and end up with more green energy cards. And Rhino also has a bit more synergy with cards like Fabrication Module. Could also be Grixis, and then Splash Black for Disintegration and Fanhauler. Although I don't have much of the artifact mana fixing, like Map or the Prophetic Prism. So maybe Teamer Energy is still the way to go, and just hope to pick up some attunes. A Rebel, pretty nice alongside cards like the Map or Unbridled Growth to enable Revolt. Here, there's an Aether Theorists or a Furious Reprisal as kind of our options. Reprisal can definitely be awkward if the opponent has a larger creature we need to deal with, so I'm not the biggest fan. I think I'd take the Theorists. Alright, perfect. Rogue Refiner. Sadly, in the same pack as Prism and Map, which would be a nice mana fixing. But not gonna pass up on a Rogue Refiner. Turtle also would have been fine. So for now, I'm just taking all the cards with energy on them. And then we'll have to figure out our mana situation. Hopefully pick up a bit of fixing. Aether Hub also helps. And then we've got Map, Prism, Attune with Aether, the Wanderer in green. So there's no shortage of mana fixing here. How about a bit of ramp with Druids? How good is Armorcraft Judge? Don't have that many plus one counters. Probably take the Druid here over Malfunction. So it could be blue-green splash red for Champion Brawler. Maybe Pyrohelix. Moray and Turtle, another pretty late Vengeful Rebel. Looking at my curve, I guess I could use a 4-drop. There's also Chandra's Revolution, which is fine removal. But I think I just want a energy creature to go with our other energy synergies. I mean, Spire, let's see, how many copies do I have? 0? Yeah, at the very least it's a good rare draft. Serpent would be a little pricey in this deck, since we don't have that many artifacts. So it's not amazing. And Gremlins also looks kind of medium, so I'm not passing up on much. And maybe we can play the Spire for fixing. So, a little bit regretting the Brawler over Attune with Aether pick. Here, do I want Garrison or Serpents? Maybe the Serpent still. So we're definitely pretty deep into blue. Red and green is pretty split at the moment. Not gonna play Self-Assembler if we only get one copy. Alright, we got the Wanderer, so that's fixing. And an Appetite's definitely main deckable. So it's looking more like blue-green splash red. And I may or may not splash Brawler, Pyrohelix, and Champion here. Could just be straight blue-green. Alright, Turtle's pretty nice here. Definitely playing that one. And we might play an Infusion, so getting some pretty nice cards late. Ooh. This pack has some goodies. I mean, Pia's just an awesome card by itself, doesn't need much help. Definitely worth splashing for, even if it's better if we're main reds to use the ability multiple times. There's another Champion, which would be awesome. Hunter Weeks, okay. And then another Self-Assembler we can hope to wheel. So here's between Champion and Pia. Yeah, I mean, I'll probably just take Pia. And then the red splash is looking better. Ooh, nice. Rishkar is awesome. The Kokshe module would also be great, but I can't pass up on Rishkar. And then hope to wheel Tiger or another Theorist. Pfile would also be okay. Tampering, definitely main deckable, but better in an aggressive deck, and probably not amazing on the splash here. Warlord Maker is a little slow, but it can help us end grindy games. And then there's Growth as kind of awkward mana fixing. I might just take the Warlord Maker here, since our late game's kind of lackluster at the moment. Alright, can take Druid or Leave in the Dust. I'm pretty light on interaction, so I'll take the Leave in the Dust here. And then I've got the option between Druids, Pfile, Rebuke. Rebuke seems medium here. I've got one already. I don't hate another Druid of the Cowl. Seems better than Seed Sculptor with what we're trying to do. And Ice Over is also kind of medium. It's kind of close here, Pfile and Druid, actually. Ooh, nice. Take a Stomper. Over Pfile. Also goes quite nicely with the double Druid we just picked up. So still not a ton of red fixing here. I mean, there's still a chance I'm just straight blue-green if I don't find any fixing whatsoever. First picked Pia, which I guess is just a nice rare draft, and I don't think we pass up on too much in that pack. I guess a Hunt a Week. Don't mind Outrider. Double Druid also makes Warlord Maker a bit more palatable. So yeah, I'm probably just not going to splash the red at this point, since we have enough playables. Malfunction would be okay. But I kind of want a rare draft. Alright, probably going to play two Self-Assemblers now. And that gives us a bit more late game, and a Pfile, nice. Alright, so we'll get rid of the red cards. Could have had a Hunt a Week, but we've got a Pia instead. And then, gonna make a couple cuts here. Not a great Metallic Rebuke deck, so that can probably go. Implement is cuttable. I don't hate Wild Wanderer now that we have a few more mana sinks. And then in terms of energy payoff cards, Turtle can spend energy, Swooper makes tokens, Theorist can scry, Thief can draw, Rhino gets counters, so we've got quite a few energy sinks here. Yeah, I don't think Growth is going to change the fact that I'm not splashing red. Just take another Moray. So, what are we thinking here? Could play an Ice Over. So, don't have any attunes, just two druids. I think 17 lands is fine. I've got a few expensive things to spend our mana on. In terms of interaction, Ice Over, Appetites, Infusion, sort of. Got a couple mana sinks, Leaving the Dusts. So, I like all the 1 and 2 drops. At 3, Drake is cuttable, Implement is cuttable. I like the rests. And then at 4, I could easily take out one of the Morays. I like Peafowl a decent amount. Wild Wanderer seems okay, giving us access to more mana. And Outriders, also kind of whatever here. Don't have a ton of synergy with it, just a 4-4 Trample for 4. And I've got a couple Self-Assemblers and Stompers that kind of fill a similar role. The 1-1 token, I guess, helps with a Serpent potentially. I think Moray has more synergy in the deck. So I'll cut Outrider, Implement, and Drake. And then my win conditions are Sky Skiff, Whirler Maker making tokens. We can just kind of beat down the opponents with Self-Assemblers and Stompers. Serpent can become unblockable. And then we've got the late game of Fabrication Module as well. And then one more cut between Infusion and Ice Over. I don't hate Infusion if we're trying to attack with large creatures and the opponent tries to double block. So it might be better than the Ice Over here. And then, yeah, 17 lands, double druids. We've got plenty of places to spend our mana between Serpents, Module, Warlord Maker. And then Self-Assembler finding another copy gives us something else to do. So that seems okay. And then the split of blue and green mana is pretty even. I've got a lot of creatures that make green mana for my double green cards, not that I have many of them. So you could make the case that we should play more blue, because if we find one green source, we'll have access to double green. Yeah, I guess I can buy that. Yeah, I think this is the deck. Don't think I need Spire of Industry. Didn't see anything else amazing in the sideboard. Alright, turn to Druid of the Cowl. And then we've got Druid and Wanderer to give us more mana for Warlord Maker, which is perfect. And Wanderer can trade for Brawler. And then Self-Assembler is not a bad follow-up. A Long Tusk Cub, that's a good one. Why? Self-Assembler. Why can't you wait one more turn? Feels bad, man. I'll decline. I only have one opponent. Yeah, those are all powerful cards. So they could attack with both, but if they spend energy, then they can't pump the cub anymore. Mostly just generates 3 energy here, or yeah, 4 energy, I guess. Try and stall out the grounds, and then hopefully take over with Warlord Maker. They've got some sort of instant here. Power Helix. Well, our opponent's almost an empty. But if a cub gets out of hand, it's pretty difficult to beat. All right. They chose the wrong color of mana here to tap down. All right, opponent's on empty. If I draw land, probably play Theorist and Warlord Maker. If not, we can Theorist and Thief. Alright, so Cub is attacking. So they can pump it 3 times up to a 6-6. So, seems like a pretty simple double block. Serpent could be great. Yeah, I think I'm still gonna double spell here. So 5. I don't mind just trading the Mori here. But I could also block with a Thief to get some free energy. I guess if I then double block and pump Mori twice, I would lose the Thief as well. So maybe that's not so great. I'm taking a bit of trample damage. I guess this is acceptable. Kind of wanted to play the Thief just to be mana efficient. Ooh. Well, best cherry is bad news. That's definitely going to beat me in a long game. So, Warlord Maker can draw with Thief end of turn. Could draw now. Probably want to wait so I can block the Aether Seer. Kept the card on top. Yep. And at this point, I value drawing a card more than scrying with the Theorist, because lands are still good at helping me use Whirler Maker, play Serpent. And of course, spells are spells. Finding an appetite for Bestiary, I guess, would be kind of the priority. But I'm by no means guaranteed to find it if I scry. So this is 6 mana to become unblockable. Don't know if it's going to be fast enough to just activate this 4 times. My opponent's going to have accumulated a lot of card advantage in the meantime. Yeah, opponents aboard the value train here. Could make Serpent unblockable. That's my entire turn, basically. Could attack, hope they block a certain way, and then leave in the dust. But I feel like my opponent would probably block with everyone. Maybe my best bet is hoping my opponent does only like double or triple block, and then leave in the dust gets them, and I can still use Whirler Maker. Alright, opponent takes it, so I guess they saved me the 6 mana. Seems okay. Can scry with a Theorist here. Oh, I forgot to scry. Oops. Untethered Express. I will be bouncing that one. I guess I can wait. Fabrication module. So 6, 7, 8, 9. Not quite enough for lethal. But we're getting close. So if I can put them to 5 and then kill with the serpent, that would be fine. So I can activate module. get an energy, put counter on whatever, probably the Thopter, and then Turtle can also attack, spend 2 energy to get a counter. So we're talking 3 plus 5 is 8, puts into 7. And then next turn, I should have enough mana for Serpent, Unblockable, and Module to get another counter. So that would be another 8. So I think that's okay. Opponent replays Express, I go to 5. I've got, I guess, only 2 blockers. So block, block. Take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I guess it doesn't work. Alright, so I guess change of plan. We'll just send in the Serpent and try and get there in 3 turns. And I can decide if I want to get a counter or a Thopter. Boar's pretty scary. So I'm guessing a plus 1 counter is going to be better for me here. Seems fine. And then do I draw? Opponent's at 10. Probably. Well, that's a draw. So now Serpent attacks. Don't have to make it unblockable. If they chum, that's fine by me. So now a Serpent is lethal by itself. We somehow out top decked the Bestiary, which doesn't happen often. Yeah, you can draw 3. Alright, make sure I click on the right option here. Have opponent targeting you draw 3 cards. Take action. GG's. Decent hand. Opponent on full-on teamer energy. Man. We keep playing against these constructed starts. I guess it's because all the energy decks look the same as limited decks. So one thing I could do here is screw the skiff. Play Rishkar. And have a bigger skiff. And then we'll stay back to block the Voyager. Gotta hope they don't have a pump spell or a removal here. I feel like I gotta play the self-assembler before I draw the second one. Alright, we did it. We finally got value. Think assembler can even attack. A rhino. And I'll just crew here. I guess we'll make them decide to spend energy first. One, two, death touch actually pretty effective here. See what we draw. Ooh, fabrication module. That's great. So now I don't hate module and I kind of just chill. And then we can take over with fabrication module. Don't really want to trade assembler for renegade. Alright, opponent's on empty. Board is stalled. And we've got sky skiff, fabrication module, and eventually P-file. Can still appetite if needed. So how do we want to block Brawler? Could go Refiner Amore, so we don't take any trample damage. Alright, that was to be expected. So I can Appetites. No, actually I can use Module here, thanks to the Skyskiff having a counter from Rishkar. So we'd go up to a 4-5. I guess that's still not enough. But might as well use Module. And then... where do I put the counter? I guess on the... Thriving Turtle, maybe? And then Peafowl can block the Voyager now. And if they don't make me use it, I can just activate Module again. So I'm pretty happy they didn't attack. Because now I get to use Fabrication Module. And we're getting close to the point where we want to make aggressive attacks. Think I'll wait one more turn. Where to put the counter. Their blockers are pretty small. Cub can grow up to a 4-4. So maybe putting it on the Wanderer is fine. Swooper's nice too. So Swooper can come down and get a counter on itself. So I think we're good to get pretty aggressive. Turtle can pay to get a counter. If I attack with everyone, yeah, it's probably fine. Still have modules, kind of a combo trick. Can also appetite one of my artifacts if I want to gain two. So I've got quite a bit of flexibility here. Possible I should have played Swooper pre-combat to put the counter somewhere else. But I was planning on putting the counter on the Swooper itself so it can block Voyager. But I maybe could have done the math to figure out if that counter was necessary when making this attack. But it was pretty complicated. So right now we would have lethal, so they have to block with one more creature. So if I pump Moray and put a counter on it, it doesn't die. Because yeah, right now we only have 9 with a counter 10. So everything dies. And I can't think of too many cards that win the opponent the game next turn. They're left with a Voyager and a Cub. Hunt a week could have done its plus one counter and removal in one card. Yeah, I guess we lost to Hunt a week. GG's. Right, nice hands. 2, 3, 4. Gonna be taking quite a bit of damage from the lookouts. Opponent on black white. Yeah, the lookout looks unassuming, but if you can pair it with a card like Skyskiff, it can definitely do a lot of work. I'll trade. Don't have a great block on the squad this turn, so we'll have to take three. So we'll take three. Stuck on single green, so I would like to play my green cards if possible. So Rhino plus Theorist here. And we're starting to stall out the grounds to the point where eventually Skyskiff could reign supreme. But we'll see. Fine with the double block. I'm not gonna put Skyskiff in harm's way. Thief could also come in handy. I'm gonna be sad if I draw the module after playing all my energy creatures now, but I would still be pretty happy to draw it. And now we can start scrying with the Theorist as well. So we can play Moray and Turtle. And then... don't think I'm attacking with the Skyskiff just yet. I don't think I upkeep Scry, because I could use this to maybe crew. We'll just do the end step Scry. Might also want to keep land in hand in case of a discard spell. Can also start drawing with a thief. I don't have to hold it to try and ambush. Responder, okay. Yeah, probably fine to flash in thief. Forest is better than island, at least. Can kill Chief of the Foundry. No need to do it now. Unless we want to get aggressive. But they've got two cards in hand. I'm fine kind of slow playing it. Alright, this could work out nicely. Alright, they're gonna kill the thief. Thought they might go after the sky skiff. Can still use appetite on arrest. So I can use theorist to crew, or I can use one energy from the moray to crew. I guess I would like to scry. I think I will probably free the thief here, since we've got quite a bit of energy to draw cards with. And then upkeep. I think I'll scry. Rishkar's not bad. And then I could go full control, play Rishkar, and then with Rishkar's trigger on the stack, crew the sky skiff. Or does that not work? Yeah, I guess you need to declare your targets when you're choosing the ability, so yeah. Of course, if sky skiff's not a creature, it doesn't work. That makes sense. Rishkar and Moray. Now I can crew, but of course it's too late. So a small misplay there. Dawnfeather Eagle. So now the fact that Sky Skiff is a 2-3 instead of a 3-4 makes a pretty big difference. I guess we got one free energy. Ooh, leave in the dust. That could bounce Rishkar to maybe try it again. I guess I could do it now, since I've got the mana for it. I'll have wasted one counter, but it's probably worth it. And then do I scry? Sure. Super. Super's tricky, because it doesn't get past the eagle by itself. So it's not all that amazing. I think I bottom it for now. We get to shuffle it back. How many cards did I bottom? Two forests, a druid, and a swooper. Yeah, that's quite a bit of garbage. Yeah, I would like to find module more than anything. So let me draw firsts. Well, serpent does it too. So that was an excellent draw. So this turn I can just, let's see. If I crew sky skiff with a moray. Yeah, I guess we'll just play serpent for now. And then we'll make the Rishkar play next turn. Take three. And a skiff. I'll just keep my four energy for now. Ooh, nice. Alright, we found all the cards we wanted. Fabrication module. Can crew the skiff with theorists. Play Rishkar. Probably put one on the serpents. And then I could tap skiff, but I probably want that on defense. So if I want to use module, I guess I can just do it in the opponent's turn. Alright, we'll pass. And then next turn I can make serpent unblockable. They do have that annoying sky skiff plus night market lookout combo, so we are under a bit of pressure. Sky Skiff also gets plus one from the Chief. So good to hope they don't draw removal. Should be able to handle most creatures by just going bigger. No attacks. And then I guess for now I'll put the counter on Serpents. Stomper's amazing too. So I want to start getting in with Serpents. If I play Stomper, I'm going to be a little bit short on mana. But I guess it's okay, we'll play Stomper for now. Make sure our life total's nice and healthy. And then I can still use Fabrication Module. And the energy from module can also be spent on Thief or Theorists. Well, this is a little fishy, but I got a crew to skiff here. And I can still put a counter on it if needed. Die young to finish it off. Fair enough. So I can't save it. So I'm not going to. Unless I guess the thief draws into something. But I can't think of much. Maybe I want to start putting counters on the Stomper so that can attack as well. Don't have a ton of relevant cards left, but I guess we'll still scry. Don't really want to shuffle with a Wanderer. Can I decline to draw? It's a May ability, so I guess I don't have to search. But for now, I think it's time to get in with the Serpents. And then the Stomper attack goes up to 6 toughness. I should probably wait on the Stomper. And we'll just use Module. I will be taking quite a bit of damage from the Skiff, so I do have to kind of apply a bit of pressure here. More tokens. So the ground is getting pretty stalled, so Serpent's kind of my only way to apply pressure right now. So I think I'll keep pumping Serpent now. And then I might have to keep Theorist back on defense to play it safe. Ooh, that's a draw. Alright, so now we've got Sky Skiff covered. So this is 4 mana, so might not be able to make Serpent unblockable this turn. I'm still taking one from the Lookout, but that's manageable. And then I can just Whirler Maker and Module. Module also just a good combo with Rishkar, as it turns out. Could try and take damage to eventually make a 4-4 Thopter to block Skiff, but that's gonna take a while. I want to avoid the all eggs in one basket situation by putting more counters on Serpent, but they do have a lot of power and toughness on the ground, so I don't think Stomper's gonna successfully get in. And then I guess I'll scry. Peafowl's not bad. So Serpent becomes unblockable. And then do I play Peafowl, keeping a blue mana? Or do I just Whirler Maker this turn? I have 2 creatures with counters, so I don't have enough to use Whirler Maker Ents. Module here, so I guess Peafowl blocking is better. How many creatures do I have on defense? Probably enough. If they draw and Spire Charge, I could be in trouble, but I guess that was going to be the case no matter what. So this is a bit of a precarious turn if they have a pump effect. But if we can get through this, we should be fine. Ooh, ouch. That's bad. That's what I wanted to avoid. So everything has vigilance too, so it's not like we've got a crackback. 4, 5, 6, 7 attackers. I've got 6 blockers. Can't really afford to take too much damage here. I guess we can take out Chief of the Foundry. And then probably keep Peafowl alive and take 4 from Skiff. So this goes there. There. The token will die after taking 2. This seems fine. And this will also be a trade after the Chief dies. And then I'll take 4 down to 4. Next turn I can use Peafowl and Warlord Maker to prevent taking damage from the Flyers. So I don't think we're in too much trouble, just gotta be careful at 4 life with a lookout draining us. So Serpent becomes unblockable. I don't think I have enough for lethal, do I? I've got 4 blockers, I've got an unblockable attacker, and then 4 attackers, 1 tramples. Does it trample for enough is a question. I guess we're getting kinda close. And I guess Puzzle Knot gives him an extra blocker too, so I don't think I can go for lethal this turn. So I'll just play it safe. I guess I gotta remember I don't have Rishkar for mana anymore. That's actually pretty bad, because now I can't Peafowl and Warlord Maker. So I'm going to 1 here. Yeah, I was kind of expecting to be able to give Peafowl flying and still make a token with Warlord Maker, but I guess with Rishkar dying that's no longer the case. So I'm essentially at 1 life here. That's fine. I can block the Eagle and then take 2 from Skiff, 1 more from Lookout, go to 1. Alright, opponent's going for it. Hopefully no pump spells. And then between making a token or giving Peafowl flying, I guess we play around make obsolete by giving this flying. And that's all I can really do. Alright, I guess I'll scry. I'm surprised we didn't draw a self-assembler yet. Shows up just in time. Well, I think we gotta go for it. Question, do I attack with everyone? I mean, I'm dead if they get to untap, so might as well. In case they have some sort of removal for Serpent, but I doubt it. GG's. Oof, close game. Ended at 1 life. Yeah, I should have been a little bit more careful. Although I guess I did want to present lethal with Serpent in 2 turns, so maybe it was still the play to put myself in that situation. Yeah, we had some very close games. Self-assembler was a bit of a disappointment, since in the three games where I drew it, I drew both copies twice, I believe. And then the one loss was against a pretty good black-white opponent, so yeah, overall, can't complain. Feels like our deck overperformed a little bit. Let's crack some packs. War of Invention could set up some fun combo decks. Another Karizev's Expertise. We'll leave that one for Constructed too. Every now and then, if you've got the red-black sacrifice deck, it could be playable. But here I would usually take Responder. Padim can also be a fun build around. Goes well with big vehicles. Engineer, great in the red-black aggro decks. Baral's Expertise, pretty decent too. I'm also a fan of Prophetic Prism to set up those multicolor decks so you can play all those powerful multicolor cards on the splash. And Dark Intimation's a bit difficult to cast, so maybe if you're the multicolor deck with lots of fixing you can get there, or if you're just like a Grixis Artifact deck. And then both Skywhaler Shot and Winding Constrictor are perfect. Pack one, pick one. It's kind of close between Constrictor and Shot. Constrictor, of course, a more powerful card once it gets going, but it does commit you to two colors, although one of those is green, which gets ample mana fixing, so playing Constrictor in like a three-color energy deck is totally viable. And you, of course, get to synergize with Fabricate plus one counters as well. And a Blooming Marsh, good fixing for Constructed mainly. Underhanded Design's also a nice one, especially in like a blue-black control deck where you get to make some Thopters or Servos and drain the opponent to death. And then we've seen the power of Gearseeker Serpent, great finisher. Alright. So that was a fun draft with lots of interesting games as well, so yeah, Kaladesh, pretty fun set. There's a lot going on between energy, all the artifact cards, and yeah, I find that they've balanced things out compared to the original Kaladesh and Aether Vault. The set seems a little bit less aggressive. There's fewer cards like Renegade Freighter that can just run people over, so it feels like you can play some of these longer grindy games where decisions matter, and that's what I'm all about, so pretty happy with the limited environment so far. But for now, I want to thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed, and as always, have a nice day. I also want to thank all my patrons for being part of the channel, and you can become a patron yourself today and decide the topic of future videos over at patreon.com/legendvd.